pumping CO2 into the atmosphere, this is what we're going to get.
Coral reefs will cease to exist by mid-century.
Yep. 35 years from now.
In the Philippines, it's easy to see. The ocean provides. The Philippines sits at the apex of the Coral Triangle, often referred to as the Amazon of the Seas. This area contains the most biodiverse oceans in the world, and there are more types of coral than anywhere else on Earth.
So here we are.
This is the fish market.
You said that fish in general is 80% of the Filipino
diet. The middle income and lower income diet.
It's clear the demand for seafood is huge, but things are changing.
You're saying that the fishermen are reporting that these stocks are getting smaller and smaller and smaller. So catch, like the yield is smaller and the actual fish themselves
are
getting smaller.
The actual fish size is getting smaller, the yield is much higher, it's much harder to catch.
The types of fish available at the market are changing too. Renee tells me there's no better way to understand the importance of the reefs to the people here than to watch them at work. Senan is a third generation fisherman. He and his son Jory make daily trips to spear fish for the family. This father and son are so in tune with the ocean, they almost look like they belong underwater. But the fish they're hunting for are nowhere to be found. Senan usually serves up what he finds on the reefs, but today, it's canned fish.
Josh.
Yes, please. Today when we were watching, we saw that there wasn't really much for you to catch there.
Yeah.
Does that happen a lot?
Night tulo,
hard low.
3 days.
Out of a week sometimes, no catch, 3 days out of a week.
So then, can they still exist off of what remains?
They should.
Is he happy that his sons and daughters are finding different opportunities and moving off the island? Or is he sad that that way of life is broken now?
Para kumingaw.
Oh, he wants them back. He'd rather
have them on the island.
He wants them together. Kung naray isda, kompleto raw ang tamo.
Kompleto raw.
He'd rather there was enough fish. He'd rather they were off together. I'm tearing up. I didn't expect that answer.
I mean, it breaks my heart that in his perfect world, he'd be able to draw his family back to him. But if the island won't support you, you can't stay.
Yeah.
Right?
It frustrates me that those who are contributing the least to climate change are the ones who will suffer the most. Overfishing and pollution are taking a huge toll on the region, but climate change threatens to make things much worse. 5 years ago, a storm tore through parts of the marine reserve surrounding the island, and this is the result. Weakened by bleaching, the coral reefs were more susceptible to harm than ever before. I can't help but think of Ove's future scenario tanks on Heron Island. Those grim predictions seem already true. Could this be the future of all coral reefs?
Those are already protected areas. They're healthier than most
of the reefs.
Normal reefs. So if they have a hard time with that damage,
then
what more
a
reef
rest.
That's under other stresses?
I can't help but wonder, what will happen to all of the people in all of these towns all over this region when their source of food and income slowly disappears?
I don't think people realize the magnitude of that. Because if we can't get our food protein from the sea, we'll start doing it in land.
Right.
And we don't have enough land.
There's some serious security issues around that.
Definitely. Because once this part of the world is hungry, I mean, where do we go?
Right.
You know, if you go around the Coral Triangle, in all the states that actually depend on the coral reefs, like Malaysia and Papua New Guinea and Indonesia, it's the same problem.
So you're talking then about a population of tens
at least
and
about
hundreds
380
of millions.
Million, maybe.
People.
Yeah, I think that's about the ballpark. If we don't stop what we're doing.
I don't mean to laugh, but that's shocking. Wow.
Together, the Philippines, Indonesia, Malaysia, Papua New Guinea, the Solomon Islands, and Timor-Leste have a population of about 384 million. By comparison, Syria, currently in the midst of the world's biggest refugee crisis, had a pre-war population of only around 23 million. I'm wondering how the government here responds to such a looming threat to its population and what it might mean for the rest of the world.
The issue of climate change in the Philippines, for us, is a national security matter. It's not just environmental security. It affects every aspect of our lives, yes.
And do you think it's too late?
It's not too late. No one should be defeatist to say it's too late, because we are in an emergency room and no time should be lost.